Hello, friends, and welcome back to 7 Days to Die with your host, Rongo the Bold. And welcome to Season 3 of my Let's Play series. We are in Alpha 10-4, B9. I do hear there might be another hotfix momentarily, but we will go ahead and continue on. Hopefully, we won't have any save issues. Hopefully. So, I'm going to mix things up a little bit. We're going with a game name of Nirvana. I have tested that seed out, and we do have a deserty biome to hopefully the south of the hub city. So, that's going to be our home sweet home. We are going to be living in the desert this time. May not start off in the desert. We might do some looting beforehand. We'll kind of see how things go. Obviously, where the zombies drive us, we will go. So we are going to pick it up this time and do it on Survivalist. Survivalist is the one step above, you know, one step down from insane on difficulty level. So it's going to be much tougher to kill the zombies in this one. So I thought that might just add a little more to the fun of killing zombies. No more one-hit kills. So I was playing my previous series on Nomad. So this is two steps up as far as difficulty goes, which is normally, I don't normally play at Survivalist. I normally play at Warrior. Or on the multiplayer server I play on Insane. So Survivalist will be a new playthrough for me. We're going with a 40-minute day, 35% night. We're going regular zombies, normally aggressive, not feral. And I did bump the loot abundance up as well to 75% from my normal 50%. And the reason why is I'm hoping to get some more of those rare drop items like a nail gun and chainsaw and auger, just to show you guys how those things work. So loot respawn 30 days, drop on death, everything 90, very high airdrops, so all the basic normal other stuff other than that. So it should be a slightly more challenging run through with the little tougher zombies, and they hit a little harder, or they hit a lot harder. I probably one-shot it a few times, so it'll be fun. And I just want to, you know, big shout out to all my followers for getting me this far. I can't believe I made it to Season 3 of 7 Days to Die. You guys have been great, so supportive, and I really appreciate that. So let's go ahead and kick off Season 3 with a bang. And I'm probably going to spawn right into like a dog pound or something like that. I'm sure that would just be the perfect start to the perfect game. 3, 2, 1, here we go. Snow, fuck me. And desert. Snow and desert. I can live with this. This works for me. And there's Hub City. Okay, so right at the corner of desert. Screw you, Stompy Man. Oh, and there's a nurse. I don't even have a freaking rock yet to pound her in the head. So quickly grab a rock. So first thing you want to do, grab your rock, grab your grass, grab a couple grasses. I'll grab three just because I want to be making a crossbow as soon as I can as well. And then we need a stick. Sticks look like, there's bushes that look like sticks. They don't look like sticks, they are stick bushes. Are you hunting me, bitch? Where'd you go? Yeah, she's probably hunting me. Alright, let's loot this place up a little bit. I'm looking for a stick bush. So basically they will be a little branchier, I guess is the word. Come on, I need some scrap metal, not brass. Brass is not that helpful right now. Grab these easy sorts of wood. You don't have to do anything with them, you just grab them. I don't want the glass. Glass is used to make glass jars. But we have sand. We're going to be in the desert. We're not going to have a shortage at all of sand to make jars. We will probably actually build the walls of our house out of jars. Wait, that might be a little fragile. Maybe we won't do that. All right. On second thought, no, we're not going to do that. Okay, I'm looking for bird's nests and a stick. Oh, hold on. I'm a moron. I just told you guys that it was always good to pick up those pieces of wood. So let's go in our inventory. We'll leave the torch for right now. We'll put our bottle of water away, our can of chili away. Keep that on our hot bar. So, first thing we're gonna do, take this aged wood, break it down to wood planks. Oh yeah. Turn those into sticks. Oh yeah. So, let me grab those guys. We're gonna turn these into plant fibers. Turn these into sharp rocks. Hell yeah. Okay, crossbow. So, I'm gonna try and remember when I make things to put the recipe up so you guys can see where the recipe is and not just that I happen to know all the recipes by heart. There we go. One crossbow. Craft that puppy. And then one. That's axe. Alright, so we get our. That. You can put more than one. It only uses the thing because we only have one of them to make. So there we go. Get those back in our inventory. So now we need feathers. Feathers is our current goal in life. Am I being hunted? No, I'm not being hunted. Okay, perfect. Let's see. What do we need? All we now have is this as far as a weapon goes. So let's be very cautious. We are still looking for more rocks, and we need feathers. So feathers is our priority right now, so we can make some crossbow bolts. I'm hesitant to venture up here, but there we go. Where's that 16 there? Beautiful. So take these feathers. We're gonna do bolt. Crossbow bolt is feathers, sticks, and sharp stones. Boom. All right. We now have our first weapon. Load that puppy up. Always load it. It does not come loaded, and it can be a surprise when you first make it. You pull it up, aim it at a zombie, and you get a click, and then he hits you in the head and kills you. So avoid that at all costs, folks. Avoid the dying. And I want to point out that in my previous Let's Plays, by this point I've probably died twice. So I am doing much better on this playthrough than I have been, and I am going to be much more cautious. I'm going to see if I can, how long I can go without dying. That's going to be my personal challenge. I apologize if you can hear any noise in the background. One of my roommates had a get together last night and now is cleaning the place, so there's lots of clattery bits going on. All right, got a lot of rocks. That's just fine, but where, oh, where are the birds' nests? Be cautious. Zombies, I mean, I'm not see don't seem to be a lot of zombies around. All right, let's head up this way. So these are the stick bushes. These things here will give you like multiple sticks, and these also will give you sticks if you punch them, so that's good. All right, so we're at the end of that biome area, and we've got a maple forest, looks like. Maple forest, home of the chrysanthemum flower, useful for making red planks. I love my red planks. So the big question I've got for you guys in this season is, what do you guys want me to build? I've had some comments of possibly building a nice big castle in the sand. Or do you guys want me to? I hear you. I hear you. I'll leave. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to bother you. Oh shit! Didn't even see that guy right there in front of my face. See ya. Holy crap, he was like Stompy McStomp Town. Alright, let's grab more of these guys. Alright, holy shit. Okay, so I was starting to say before I had the shit scared out of me by a zombie that do you guys want me to build a place, or do you want me to reinforce an existing location? So let me that's the very first question we've got in the comments. So just let me know. Oh, I can still one shot. That's good. Alright, who's you guys look like you're going elsewhere. Oh, you're coming for me, huh? Awesome. Okay, these guys take more than one shot. Oh crap, oh crap, this is not good. I really want to be able to loot these girls up. Okay, sorry, I got a little focus here. A little focus. I'll take your fat buddy. I'm gathering up goldenrod and cotton. The reason I'm getting the cotton is because I'm going to be making a sleeping bag as quickly as I can, so that I can have a static spawn point. Hi, honey. These guys are hard to hit in the head because they. Oh, yeah, sure, yeah. Oh, yeah, there you go. Take that, buddy. Oh, that Stompy's coming over, too. He decided to play. Oh, come on. Yeah, just. And I'm out of crossbow bolts. Oh, great. Not a good time to run out of crossbow bolts. Let's search up the cheerleaders. Who else died over here? Go, great. Got another one. Okay, I've got enough to make some more crossbow bolts. Let's just get a little bit of distance on these guys. Alright, quickly. Turn those into those. Okay, I'm just gonna back up some more. Okay, bolt. Oops. Crossbow bolts. I don't have any sticks. Oh crap. Okay. Back up, back up, back up, back up, back up. Okay. So I gotta turn those other aged woods into sticks. Bolts. Okay. Okay, good. Okay, we're still okay. Okay, let's kill this guy. Oh! Let's try to kill this guy. Okay. Let's kill Stompy. Three of these bastards, they take so many hits. Okay. Come on. Come on. Oh god. Don't want to miss right now. Don't want to miss. Okay. Am I clear? I'm clear. Okay. Alright, let's loot these guys up really quick. Whew. Being cautious. Being very cautious. Oil pain pills, nice. Take the brass. I'm a big believer in collecting brass and paper early on. Even though it usually is an inventory suck, it is also so freaking helpful later on in the game. Okay, you got bird's nest. Okay, good. More crossbow bolts. All right. Oh, hello. Hello there, buddy. Okay, off him. All right, let's. Whew. Okay, more bolts, more bolts. We seriously need a tree. We need to knock a tree down. So our next thing. Oh, perfect shot. I am a crossbow god. On the move. Okay, on. You can't afford this right now. Okay. Shut up, spider. Okay, whew. Let's try and loot everybody we can here really quick. Hoping for scrap metal. I don't need nails or very much a luxury right now. Okay, we've got enough cloth now to make a sleeping bag, so that's our next order of business, a sleeping bag. Okay. We're gonna live right on the edge right here for right now, just to give ourselves a little bit of a minor breather. We have this area cleared out, so the zombies shouldn't be bothering us for a few moments at least. Oh crap, we got more over there. Okay, so sleeping bag. First thing we'll do, sleeping bag. Sleeping bag. So it's just a pattern across the bottom. We don't have enough there, so we make cloth. Cloth fragments made from cotton stacked top editor. Right click to split in half. So then we got cloth. We have seven. We needed six. Boom. Sleeping bag on the ground, and that gives us our spawn point. Woohoo! We're invincible! Take on the world, oh yeah. Okay, tree. Need a tree. It's 11 o'clock. Not doing too shabby. Alright, so the first order of business is going to be to get ourselves... what do we need first? We really need the forge book, so... I think we'll run into the desert biome and see what kind of... I don't know why I'm gathering those. I don't really need those. See what we got, if there's a hub location there. And if so, we'll spend the night in the hub location. So I'm going to gather some wood first. It's easier to gather wood outside of the hub. Outside of the desert biome, which just has those aged woods, which are easy to pick up, but you don't get much off of them. You get 8... Hello. Huh, okay. Let's take a couple of these, turn those into that, into sticks. Booyah. Booyah. Bolts. Bolts, yes, please. So feathers are our limiting factor right now. Oh, sure. Okay, and these guys, like I said, these guys are a pain in the ass to hit in the head because they're always wiggling their heads. Hey, honey. Oh, yeah. Nice. Vitamins. So vitamins give you half a point of wellness, which, so wellness is how much your maximum health is and your maximum stamina. So every time you die, you take a 10-point hit to your wellness, which can suck down to a minimum of 30 wellness. Take your paper, leave your fishing lead. Lead's usually pretty darn easy to get in the game because you can mine it, and it mines pretty easy, so I'm not too concerned about that. So we're gonna go into the desert on a horse with no name. Song, 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 song. All right, I'm gonna take that. Just collecting rocks because I'm a rock addict. It's a rock opera. I'd like to get a few more feathers because we only have 22 bolts, which is not a whole lot. All right, I'm gonna take a few more trees. Oh, bag. Okay. You see that bag off to my left by that stick bush? Those canvas those bags, the sporting goods bags, purses, backpacks, always have good loots. Usually a lot of food, so hoping that we're going to get some food out of that. Search up this trash as well. But I do need scrap iron. Oh, hell yeah, baby. Right off the bat, a freaking gun. Okay, we have, they come with 15 rounds in the clip. Two there, got 17 rounds. And some food. Alright. Let's go ahead and do a little crafting downing. Two fishing weights gives you a scrap lead. Brass, all your brass items can be stacked into this at the same time. And you can convert them all into scrap. So smash them all down. Get our lead together. We have no iron yet. Can gives you half of an iron. We need a full can. So let's go ahead while we're thinking about it. Turn these into plant fibers. Okay. We might as well eat because... might as well. All right, now we have two cans. Two cans can be squished down flat to scrap iron. However, I should not have done that because you need, until you can get a cooking pot, the only way to make water is to boil it in a can. And I need to have a can to do that. So we're gonna spend just a few more minutes here in the forest, and then we're gonna book ass toward the desert and see if we can find a. Just grabbing a few more rocks. All right. Marvel. I'm gonna grab some more cotton while I'm thinking about it. Now, if we do, when we do live in the desert, we have a few minor concerns. You can't. There's no water sources, so water is going to be a priority for us. And you can't grow anything on desert sand, so you have to import your soil. So we'll be over here in the desert, or over here in this forest, digging things up just to get sand to go. Oh, hell yeah! 4 cans, that's freaking awesome. Who would have thought that as a survivalist, that you'd be excited to find a garbage load of sand or cans? But oh, yeah, very happy. Okay, we got enough to make some more bolts. You just shift click and it makes the maximum that you can. So, what's our limiting factor now? Where's our feathers? Feathers are here, put those there. So let's take half of our rocks, turn them into sharp stones. I'll leave them stacked like that. Go ahead and craft up some more sticks. You can never have enough crossbow bolts. So every time you have a chance, make more crossbow bolts. They stack to 250 in your inventory. So you can stack a whole small shit ton. Okay, I want to leave by 1400, which is 2 o'clock. It's getting a little late in the day. I'm a little nervous. I'm gathering goldenrod so that I can make goldenrod tea someday, or at least plant goldenrod. So that'll be the thing. All right, get more goldenrod, a few more rocks. Of course, rocks can be found in the desert as well, but I'm just being paranoid. All right, excellent, excellent start. I cannot believe we have not died. See, had to go and open my damn fool mouth. Let's get this nurse. Nurses are always a high priority target for me because they can drop bandages, they drop all kinds of first aid stuff, basically. Grain alcohol, really? I can't hit you. Beakers. Just they're like the epic loot queens. Or, empty jars. Okay, let's get these guys and then let's get the frick out of here. Yes! I kind of anticipate where their head's gonna be. I anticipated that one really poorly. Oh, come on, that was horrible. And get this guy. All right. Pain pills? Hell yeah. Very sure up. Alright. Let us get. Bones are used to make bone shivs, and I'm just not a fan of the bone shiv. It's a close range weapon. So you gotta get right in their faces, and I would rather stay as far from a zombie as I can. Alright, this is it. We are already late to our own party. Where'd our gonna find our sleeping bag, pick it up. Oh yeah. I will take all of those I can get. I don't wanna leave the forest. The forest is my happy place. It's my happy place. It's okay, Rongo. The desert is your new happy place. We started on the Bearded Bob's multiplayer server. Started a new 10-4 game and decided to go into the desert. And yeah, not a good start to the game. We it was on feral mode, so obviously it's a little tougher. Feral insane. And the zombies just, yeah, it was not pretty. I think I'm the only one who actually died. I seem to be the death magnet. All right, where's our sleeping bag? Where is it? There it is. Okay, let's pick this up. Let's head out. So I'm going to teach you a little bit about how to survive in the desert. So first thing, sand everywhere. Pick this up. Pick up your aloe. Aloe and cotton gives you healing bandages. Aloe and jars gives you aloe, which is an immediate healing boost. I would kill you, Piggy. I would so kill you. I would just kill the heck out of you. But I don't want to carry your meat. Oh God, I really want to kill you though. Okay, all this wood, pick it up. Pick up all the woods. Aloe, and there's yucca as well. And yucca is your forest grocery store. Oh hell. Okay, let's grab those. I don't want to hang out with these guys. Ouch! Oh yeah, they hurt you. Oh nice, a club. Very nice. Very nice. Okay, oh, let's equip this club. It's not a great weapon, but you know, at this point, we'll take what we can get. Okay, so you have aloe, and you've got yucca. So you need four yucca to do anything with, and you can make a yucca juice out of them. Let's grab some more feathers. Nice. Let's go ahead and make more bolts. Whoa, okay, we need to make more stones, bolts. Get rid of this maple seed, don't need to carry that around. Okay, just gather wood and let's head. We gotta get moving. We are running low on time. It's not good. So I'm gonna grab all the aloe I can. I'm not too worried about yucca. What do we got? A spam and a honey knife. I'll take it. Not a big fan of the honey knife either, but it's scrap metal regardless, so. Feathers, yes. Book. I'll trade the book for that. Take that. Okay. I'm glad they upped this movement speed. It's a little faster than it was, which is nice. Spider. Hello, guys. How you guys doing? Just passing through. Don't worry about me, guys. It's all happiness. Okay, where am I going? That's the other question. Bag. Bag, bag, bag. Ooh, I will take. Okay, let's go to our character. I'll put this on. Take those. Put those on. Put the crafting and get the fuck out! Oh, so many bags! Don't need the shotgun receiver for now. It's a luxury. Okay. Well, I'm gonna call that an episode. I know we are kind of in the middle of nowhere and nothing's happened. But we're still alive. We've made it an entire episode, and I am still motherfucking alive. I am like a god. All right, I'm gonna kill these guys. Hit the 8 button. Put the bandage on. All right, friends, and with that, I am going to call it an episode. I will see you guys in the next episode. If you liked it, click that like button, comment, subscribe, tell your friends, your family, and your grandmother, and let me live, please!